meet somebody, they have one layer. After you know them for a while and you get to the depth of the persona, then you really understand the person. You can't understand it at the first glance. And I hope that my art has that same feeling, that when you get to look at it at first, you glance at it and you say, oh, that's nice, or it isn't nice, I like it or I don't like it. Then after you learn the history and the idea of why this was done, you can really get to the layers of life.
If you look at the work, you see that there is a lot of multidimensionality in the work. And I like the way she integrates her life.
Sheila Elias, thank you for coming to my show. I appreciate it. So this is all based on my African trip. These paper pieces are a combination of photography and collage and my idea of Africa in a very free kind of thinking way. Silvana Facchini came over and she paired it with vessels that I had done in the past. And then I finished this last painting that I've been working on 6 months. Actually thought I'd never finish it, but it's here. Enjoy. Well, you know, you can't take yourself out of the work. I mean, that's amazing.
Artwork is not distinguishable from herself. It's there inextricably locked together, which is really what Sheila's all about.
I can't explain it. It's almost like it filters into your system, and then all of a sudden you've got glitter on your face. And so one day I went to dinner, my friend who's a psychologist, I said to her, oh, I'm a little bruised. She said, what happened? I said, I fell off the copier machine. She says, you what? Well, I was copying my feet and my hands and I fell off the machine. She says, only you.
Well, after I met Sheila for the first time and I was asked to write something about her, so this is going back a long time. What I said was, she was so passionate about her art that I felt if she could eat the paint, she would.
What was the other exhibition that we did with your photographs of the building that came down?
Oh, that's gonna, that,
what
gonna
was
see.
That, what was
implosions.
That?
Explosions.
Implosion.
I got permission to stand on the roof of a building to photograph the implosion of some hotels. I got permission from the city. And then I had women in there with caution and danger signs. And don't cross this line. These pieces were done before 9/11, some of those. And people thought I did it after 9/11. But I always think artists are precognitive.
She's not afraid of exploring even things that are could be dangerous.
I want a piece of art that is both intellectual, attractive in many ways, but serious and happy, and because I'm a glass half full person. I've always been. I always see the half full. This little bird was caught in the implosion and it blew up. And it was very exciting to see that this bird was still gonna live.
I think Sheila is one of the few artists that deals with our moment in time. What is going on in the world, and she is from Miami.
You would think that she is a 22-year-old woman, you know what I mean? Because her work is very contemporary. It's not like she stopped in the 80s.
These works I did on the iPad and then had them printed with a machine that I don't own. They're kind of on plexi front and metal back. I was excited because I started working just with my finger. I don't use a pen, I don't use a pencil, on the iPad. And I love color and I love shapes, and I was able to get these all together. I went to the Aventura Apple store and I said, how do you delete this? He goes, what is this? I said, it's paintings. He said, I gotta show these. I said, I showed at the Louvre. I'm not showing at an Apple store. So he goes, you've gotta show. 5 times he came here. I showed there. Then he called Lincoln Center. And I exhibited there, and I had a show in New York with that. then it called Santa Monica, and then I showed at Hong Kong Art Basel and at the Apple Store in Hong Kong, which was kind of a riot. For 7 years, I've had a pre-Art Basel event. The night before Art Basel, I always have a studio event. This year, I said, I'm not doing it. 7 years, it's enough. And then I get a call from the Swiss Von Tobel, the bankers, and they said, we want to have a show with you again. Roberta Ganella, the curator, comes, she says, I have an idea.
And I decided, I said, let me hang the show differently.
I said, what is it? She always has great ideas. I want to do all the paintings that you have that has a horizon vision in it.
I will put it together as one piece that'll be very strong, because when you look at the horizon, that's one thing. You should be thinking of opening your minds, but putting all the paintings together like an assemblage is double. And maybe it really makes people look at it and think double hard. Where are we? Where are we looking? And she's done a wonderful work through the years that I was very lucky to be able to put together.
And that's what we're showing. Very uniquely installed.
The last piece she has is a bit of an apocalypse, but the horizon is in there and showing that there is hope. Sheila always has hope in her work.
Well, life. You know, people who died in your life, people who lived in your life, you're moved. I moved a couple of times. I remarried. I lost my husband. I, of course, have two children. And I'm a lucky person because I've had some really good stuff. Also some very difficult times, very trying and sad. But for some reason, I appreciate the good things and I don't dwell on the sad part.
Little woman loves. She loves for real. When a woman loves, she loves for real. Oh, she filled my
through canyons and mountains and tough times and childbirth, of course. Women are unique in our society and our world. You know? And I think if women ran the world, there'd be less wars. That's my opinion.
And she's got more.